Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's been almost an entire year since I've done one of these dollar store videos, so I thought it would be fun to do one for fall. I do also have a Halloween one that I will be doing here shortly. So watch out for that video if this is something that you're interested in. We're gonna start with this really simple fall sign. This is something anybody could do as long as you have a printer. You could do this one. So I made my own little fall sign here, and this is actually a printable. You can go to my Etsy shop and download it. It's only $1, and all I did was I went to Dollar Tree and I picked up this frame, which I thought would be beautiful with this sign, and it looks like it's actual wood, and that's exactly what I was looking for, was a frame that looked like it was wood. So all I'm doing here is, after I printed out this sign, I'm going to cut it out so it fits perfectly into the frame, and I made this design for an 8x10 frame, so it will print at the perfect size for an 8x10 frame. This saying, "I'm so glad I live in a world where there are Octobers," is from Anne of Green Gables, and it's one of my favorite sayings. I've always wanted a really big, huge farmhouse sign of this saying in my house. Any that I have found have been a few hundred dollars, and I just cannot get myself to spend that kind of money for one like farmhouse sign. So if I could print my own and get one of those dollar store frames, then I think $1 to $2 is definitely worth it. So here I just wanted to show you the other color I have, which I think is beautiful. And I actually went and got another frame so that I could put this one in my bedroom, and I love it in there. For this next one, I'm going to turn a glass vase that you can pick up at any Dollar Tree, and you can get any shape that you want, but I am turning this into a pottery version, so I want it to look almost like a clay pot, if that makes sense. All I did was I got a few different colors of paint from Walmart, and these are 50 cents, so you can get whatever color that you want, and I mixed up a few different colors to get the exact color I was going for. The secret here is using some baking powder, and I used a couple tablespoons in my mixture to give it that clay feeling, and when it dries, it kind of leaves like those lines. So I think the rule of thumb here is, for every cup of paint, it's 1 teaspoon. However, I used a few because I wanted it to be a thicker paint. So as I was going, I just continued to add like a few more teaspoons, and I definitely didn't even have a cup of paint here. So I probably used a total of 3 teaspoons in this amount of paint. And I love how it turned out. I ended up doing 3 coats of paint on the vase. Now I'm also going to be using the same paint for the next DIY that I show you. I'm also going to be mixing some other colors up, but I'm still using the same idea with the baking powder. So the flowers that I put in here are just dried florals I found on the mountain behind my house. So we have like a million of these all over the place where I live. And I'm sure you guys probably, no matter where you live, have some kind of natural grass or dried florals that are somewhere around you that you could just go snip a couple and put them into your vase. So this project really only cost $1 for me. All right, for this last one here, I wanted to make my own acorns. And I actually picked these up yesterday at our thrift store. I was just gonna run downstairs and try to find a couple in one of our bins. But while I was at the thrift store and I saw those there, I was like, hey, that's perfect. That way I didn't have to rummage through any of my decor and find some eggs. So all I'm doing here is I'm painting a couple of the eggs different colors. So I used that like cream color. And then I wanted like a reddish amber tone on some of the acorns, and then a light brown. So again, I just kind of mixed these up and there was really no rhyme or reason to what I did, but I did use a little bit of baking powder with each of the mixtures to give it more of like a clay look on these acorns. To finish this off, all I'm doing is hot gluing some twine around the bottom of the acorn. And as I was going, you could still see the egg through it. So all I did was I wrapped it twice. So after I do one full wrap around, I just went back over really quickly and only glued in a few spots. But they ended up turning out exactly what I envisioned. And I think they're just the cutest things ever. Okay, so I went to the thrift store today and I found this stoneware for $3. And I thought I would incorporate this into the video today just to put some decor in. While I was there, I flipped this over and this is from the Pampered Chef. So I can't even imagine how much this cost originally, but I will take it for $3. And maybe after I'm done using it for decor, I might actually use it for the purpose that it has. But I just felt with the color that it is, that it would go really well with what I am doing over in this corner. Okay guys, well that's everything for this video. Thank you so much for watching. And if you haven't yet hit that red subscribe button, make sure you do that. And we will see you in the next video.